Aslam Alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Bismillahi wa salatu wa salam ala rasulullah. My dear brothers and sisters, how much do you love the life in this dunya? And how much are you prepared for the life in the akhirah? Despite the fact that the life in this world is limited, many still live in this world as if it will never come to an end someday. They even value this world more than their religion, that they even prefer to chase after the worldly affairs and dive into the trends of this dunya while ditching their religion. And Allah says about them in the Quran in Surah Al-A'raf that الَّذِينَ اتَّخَذُوا دِينَهُمْ لَهْوًا وَلَعِبًا, those who took their religion as amusement and play. They took the deen for a joke and thought they could waste their time with the dunya in their lives. Even when Allah commanded that وَلَا تَتَّخَذُوا آيَاتُ اللَّهِ هُزْوًا, and don't take the ayat of Allah as a joke. But unfortunately, what later happened to these people? مَغَرَّتْهُمُ الْحَيَاةُ الدُّنْيَا, and the life in this world deceived them. They were deluded by the dunya, deluded by its allure and beauty, and they were pushed away from Almighty Allah Azza wa Jalla. Even after Almighty Allah warned that وَمَا الْحَيَاةُ الدُّنْيَا إِلَّا مَتَاعُ الْغُرُورِ, and what is the life of this world except a temporary delusion, they still took the dunya for the utmost priority. And what would be their punishment on the day of Yawm al-Qiyamah? فَالْيَوْمَ نَنْسَاهُمْ كَمَا نَسُوا لِقَاءَ يَوْمِهِمْ هَذَا. And Allah says, so this day we shall forget them as they forgot their meeting of this day. Meaning that Almighty Allah will treat them as if He has forgotten them completely. For Almighty Allah is the all-knowing and the all-seeing. Certainly nothing escapes Allah's perfect watch, and He never forgets anything. And Almighty Allah continues, وَمَا كَانُوا بِآيَاتِنَا يَجْحَدُونَ, because they used to reject our ayat. These are the people mentioned in the ayat before. They will cry out in the hellfire. وَنَادَى أَصْحَابُ النَّارِ أَصْحَابُ الْجَنَّةِ أَنْ أَفِيدُوا عَلَيْنَا مِنَ الْمَاهِ أَوْ مِمَّا رَزَقَكُمُ اللَّهِ. And people of hellfire will call to the people of Jannah, pour on us some water or anything that Allah has provided you with. Then the people of Jannah replied that قَالُوا إِنَّ اللَّهَ حَرَّمَهُمَا عَلَى الْكَافِرِينَ. They will say that indeed, Almighty Allah has forbidden both upon the disbelievers. It was recorded in a Sahih Hadith that the Prophet Muhammad said that Almighty Allah will say, on the day of Yawm al-Qiyamah, have I not gotten you married? Have I not honored you? Have I not made horses and camels subservient for you and allow you to become a leader and a master? He will say, yes. Allah will say, do you think that you will meet me? He will say, no. And Allah Azza wa Jalla will say, then this day I will forget you as you have forgotten me. Again, why has this happened to this set of people? Referring back to what Almighty Allah says again in Surah Al-A'raf, verse 51, وَمَا كَانُوا بِآيَاتِنَا يَجْحَدُونَ, and they used to reject our ayat. Let's reflect on how we reject the ayat of Allah via our actions. Why our speech affirms the ayat of Allah. We recite the Quran, yeah, but our actions is meaning the opposite of what is said in the Quran. How much do we forget Allah Azza wa Jalla in our lives? Isn't it time we turn back to Allah?